نحمده ونصلي على رسوله الكريم أما بعد فأعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم رب اشرح لي صدري ويسر لي أمري واحلل عقدة من لساني يفقه قولي السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. On an individual level, we try our best to be pious, honest and God-conscious. We try our best to follow the religion on an individual level. But we forget that as a community, we also have some obligations. We are a part of community in a system where the system is against Islam. And we come to know from the Quran that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَمَنْ لَمْ يَحْكُمْ بِمَا أَنزَلَ اللَّهُ فَأُولَٰئِكَ هُمُ الْكَافِرُونَ. That whosoever does not judge, does not follow the law of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala which He has revealed, then they are the disbelievers. Then he is a kafir. Then we see that وَمَنْ لَمْ يَحْكُمْ بِمَا أَنزَلَ اللَّهُ فَأُولَٰئِكَ هُمُ الظَّالِمُونَ. Those are the wrongdoers. And again we see وَمَنْ لَمْ يَحْكُمْ بِمَا أَنزَلَ اللَّهُ فَأُولَٰئِكَ هُمُ الْفَاسِقُونَ. That those who do not follow what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has revealed, His law, then those are the mischievous people. They are the source of corruption. These three fatwas, they come from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the biggest mufti. In Surah Nisa we see yastaftunak, that Allah is saying that they are asking a fatwa from you. قُلْ اللَّهُ يُفْتِيكُمْ فِي الْكَلَالَةِ. Tell them that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will give you the fatwa, which means that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is also a mufti. And all of the muftis of this world, if put together, cannot be equal to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Their knowledge is lesser with comparison to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's knowledge. So what is his fatwa? What is the fatwa of the biggest mufti? His fatwa is that those who do not judge according to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's laws which he has revealed to Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, then they are the kafirun, then they are the disbelievers. Disbelievers are not only those who deny it openly but also those who deny to follow Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's laws. Then the second fatwa, those are the wrongdoers. They are wronging themselves. And the third fatwa, they are the fasiqoon. They are the mischievous people. They are the corrupt people who cause corruption. These three fatwas come in one ruku, in the seventh ruku of Surah Maida. When we say Ashhadu an la ilaha illallah, then it is really easy to utter those words. But living our life according to it is very difficult. When we say Ashhadu an la ilaha illallah, then we mean that we represent Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's deen. We represent His laws. We represent His justice. And these things should reflect in our actions as well as sayings. But unfortunately, we are today focused only on our individual level, our own individual progress, but we have failed as a community to represent Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's system, His deen, His laws. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant us the ability to represent His deen correctly. وآخر دعوانا الحمد لله رب العالمين. سبحانك اللهم بحمدك نشهد أن لا إله إلا أنت نستغفرك ونتوب إليك. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته.